Da sind wir wieder, hier beim Airbeat Festival mit Danny Avila. Hi!
What's up, what's up?
How are you?
I'm good, I just got here. Looks amazing, can't wait to go on.
Some DJs just arrived for their gig, but I think you arrived some hours ago.
Usually I arrive to the show like pretty, like just right before my show. But tonight, you know, like there's a lot of friends here. I think I know pretty much every single artist that is playing here, so I decided to come here a little early to say hi and, you know, have a little bit of fun before my show as well.
And who did you meet?
I was just with Alesso at his restroom. I just saw Thomas go. I was with Dennis, of course, Dennis Koyu. Who else? Mac J. I saw him when he was leaving, so, you know, everyone. I'm pretty much friends with everyone here.
Here at Airbeat, you are playing on two stages, on the main stage.
Yeah.
On the second stage, you're doing a set called More.
Yeah.
What's behind that? What's the story behind that? Or why that difference?
Well, basically, you know, the main stage set is what everyone can expect from me, pretty much, or what most of the people know me for. It's like high energy set, and like, you know what I mean, right? The idea behind More is basically different music. You know, I grew up with a lot of different genres, not just like progressive house or like music that I play on main stage. I grew up with more techie stuff, with deeper kind of music. So for me, More is about telling the crowd a story, more or less. Not playing like banger, 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 but like playing, you know, up and then I bring it down, and then I play some tech house, and then I play some more energetic stuff. I play around more with the crowd. And for me, you know, that's something that now, like right now, not a lot of people is doing. Like, you know, when you play a festival, it's just about like, you know, high energy and stuff. But with that, I can actually bring back what I learned in the beginning, you know, like the actually art of DJing for me. So that's what I try to do with More.
What you learned in the beginning. So what was so special about the beginning, or what did you learn then?
Well, in the beginning when I started, which was way before like this whole like what people call EDM explosion or whatever, it was more about the actual DJing and the actual, you would not play an hour and a half set, you'd play like 3 hour set or maybe 3.5 hour set, a bit longer. You would not mix a track every 30 seconds, but you would mix a track every 5 minutes. It was a bit different. So that's actually like the way I learned in the beginning, and that's what I'm trying to do with More sometimes, you know. Sometimes if I play an hour set with More, if I play like at a festival, I play different. But if I play, even though I bring my More concept to a club and I'm playing 4 hours, it will be different than the other set. It's always different, you know, it's changing, but it's really exciting.
Was there a day in the past month or years where you met up all the other DJs and everything, you were having fun, and then you just said, okay, let's go out and let's have a party? Or is it most of the time like that everybody's going back to the hotel, wants to sleep?
No, definitely. No, I mean, there's some times, you know, where like everyone feels like having fun, like partying or whatever. I mean, with, you know, a lot of the guys, they know, like, they all have a really tough schedule, so most of the time we just try to like keep it simple and just go back to hotel. But, you know, I remember like 2 weeks ago I was in Ibiza with Nervo. Who else was I with? I don't even remember. Oh yeah, with Dubs, Nervo, with Axel and Grosso, with Hartwell, and we're all partying, having fun, you know. But there's a time for every single thing. If you want to party, you can't do it 24/7. You know.
Yeah, no, of course. How do you get along with the female fans?
Female fans?
They are, when you have a gig, they are standing in front of you, smiling and all that stuff. I mean,
it's great, it's great, it's fun.
You get to know a lot of women.
It's fun, I mean, but it doesn't really make a difference if it's a guy or a girl, you know, they're all the same. And I'm really happy when I see people, you know, with banners with my name, and like people going crazy when I'm playing, you know, or people, you know, waiting outside, you know, hotel, waiting for me to like, you know, take a picture. It's always, you know, it's always really, really great.
Is there anybody you would like to work with in the future? Like any DJ or musician you say, oh, he or she's so brilliant, that would be a dream come true?
I would really like to collaborate with Madonna, actually. Madonna, I think she's great. Even though, like, you know, she's not my type of music that I play, whatever, she's really inspiring. She's been around for so long and she's really talented, for sure. She's like the queen of music. So it's, I would definitely, maybe, you know, not even like thinking about like putting out a track, but just, I would love to have the opportunity to be in the studio with her to see how it is, you know?
Like Fede Legrand, I'm a Madonna bitch.
Yeah, yeah, or like, you know, Martin Solveig, I think he did some stuff with Madonna as well, so.
Another big point, you are reaching the 1 million point at Facebook with your fans.
Yes, that must
be quite amazing.
Yes, amazing, it's amazing.
So what do you do at Facebook? Do you post by yourself? A lot?
I try to post as much stuff as I can, especially on Facebook. My team does a lot of posting when it comes to, like, sometimes, you know, the releases or like some interviews or some, you know, when it comes more to like the promotion kind of part, but like all the pictures on the road and all the comments or when I answer people, it's always me. Yeah.
Okay, very cool. Thank you very much for the interview.
Great, thank you.
Would you sign our club sounds?
Of course.